chunk for holding onto the sonar hub housing is just too damn short. It's just getting to be a mess trying to get all these wires tucked back in there. So I went back and making a new one that has another 6 inches added to its overall length. Yeah, that should help. Sharp ass edges on there. Okay, that has got to be filed down.
I can do that if you want me to check it.
Sure. What do you think, Jess?
Hmm?
You happy?
Probably never turn it in more than 3-4 threads max.
Oh, we'll have one more.
No.
You weld downhill into it?
No, that's a lot downhill.
It's gonna look like shit or?
That's right.
What this gadget is, it's our line boring tool. It's not really a line boring tool. Those are set up to go out on a machinery and, you know, drill out where a pin goes through. This is just made to, you set a pipe into it and we can bore the inside of the pipe or clean the end of the pipe. It's something a lathe could do, but you'd need a really big lathe to do 4-inch diameter pipe. My lathe is like half the size of what you'd need. So, you know, then you need a steady rest and all this other equipment. This is something we could actually take out or somebody could build and have on a boat so they could make these sections of tube for the ROV without needing a lathe or anything like that on board. A little oil on that, probably. Yeah. 3557. So it's not ramped.
No.
Which pipe never is.
Yeah.
It's 3575.
Oh yeah, that's rough. Call those guys. Well, you won't have to do that for a while then, will you?
Hopefully not. A wonderful gift showed up today from Frank and Barbara in Germany. They're Chris Gasson's parents. You may remember Chris. He did a lot of welding and he took some beautiful photographs of the boat. One of them we turned into a poster that you can get. Take a look at this. It's a gorgeous shot that he did at night of the boat, and we threw up a phrase on it. It's available on our junk store. If you want to pay too much for a poster, there's the place to go to get it. But they sent snackies, I mean cookies and cake and candies and a wonderful thing. So thank you very much. We appreciate that.
Don't forget the dog bone.
Oh yeah, and the dog bones. Jezebel already ate hers. That didn't last but 5 minutes. She's looking to steal Tinka's now. They did a wonderful thing encouraging their son to take a trip around the world on his own. I mean, he stopped in the planet basically. And that, I tell you what, they're both language teachers, so they understand the idea of knowing cultures around the world, but to actually go and spend time in those cultures, that's really an educational experience. It's far above anything that your kids are going to get in high school, college. If they don't go, they're just not going to know. So I would encourage it. Do it. Send your kids. If you're the kid, get on a boat, a plane, a car. Doesn't matter how you get there. Make yourself, you know, flexible enough that you can live in any place at any time with any people, and you are a human that is beyond compare to others. You ate the bone, didn't you? Yes, you did. And this is what we've been doing on the ROV. We've been figuring out how to get the communication line out of the unit and up onto our umbilical. And this is working out really good. We don't even have to use brass here. I'm just going to go back and get some plastic ones. But that is a union, a plumber's union. And we epoxied in two connectors in there that are just those bullet connectors used for RC stuff a lot. and they're wired into three pairs of, it's actually a Cat 5 cable that I stripped out of the part of the Lowrance's cable that we're not going to be using. So that's one side of it, and the trick is getting a nice steady rig to hold these pins in position. So that was plugged into there while they're glued in, and that worked out real well. Did a little lathe work to get that arm made up. And so then the other side of it, you know, comes together like so. So we just got to do the other end, and we'll be in business. And once we figure out if that really works or not, not that hard to make. And I think our longer section is going to work out well too. Another trick is I made these little, they're just made out of aluminum flashing, but they hold the hose where the cables are going to run through here in position, because these are the two divots and the sonar that housing that where those cables will pass by. Putting it together without those cables being held to the side is really difficult to do. So that's looking up. Then we got to go see that cable going out will connect probably off of this port, go through here and out the top side, which is up here on this, and then head up for the tow cable and for the umbilical to the top. So it's coming along slowly, but it's coming along.